like to thank you all. I'd like to thank you all for coming here to show your solidarity with the people of Palestine, particularly with the people of Gaza, who for the last month have been under a brutal assault by the Israeli military. An assault that has seen over 1,900 people killed. An assault that has left over 430 children dead. An assault that the UN have confirmed has left 80% of the casualties confirmed as civilian casualties. We have seen 32,000 homes destroyed in 1 month. We've seen 17 hospitals destroyed, 141 schools, 6 UN shelters, and the only power plant in Gaza. This means collective punishment of a captive people, and this is illegal under international law. In the last 4 weeks, 485,000 Palestinians have become internally displaced within Gaza. In Gaza, there is no safe place to hide. This collective punishment of a captive population of 1.8 million people in an area no bigger than Dublin amounts to collective punishment. This is illegal under international law, and all the while, we see this conflict pitched in the discourse of the oppressor. We see our politicians and oftentimes our media pitch this conflict in a way that suggests Hamas is wrong to resist this brutal assault, that Hamas is wrong to take up its legitimate right of resistance. The right of resistance is enshrined in the Geneva Convention. To frame Hamas as the aggressor in this conflict. In fact, to frame any Palestinians as the aggressor in this conflict is akin to asking a rape victim why they fought back against their rapist. But of course, this recent assault is only one aspect of 66 years of the systematic oppression of Palestinian people. The West Bank has been carved up and turned into a series of disjointed Bantustans by the construction of illegal Israeli settlements. Freedom of movement is denied to Palestinians in the West Bank. Palestinians are subjected to Israeli military law within the West Bank, while illegal Israeli settlers are allowed to live under Israeli civil law. This is apartheid. Palestinian citizens of Israel who live within Israel are discriminated against and treated worse than second-class citizens every day. This is apartheid. But of course, the siege of Gaza, the siege that has been ongoing since 2007, the siege that has locked Gaza down by air, sea and land, the siege that has strangled the economy there, that has given up Gaza's autonomous control of their borders. This itself has put the people of Gaza under huge pressure, economically, physically and emotionally. This is apartheid. No ceasefire can be meaningful without a lifting of the siege. Israel acts with impunity because the international community allows it to do so. When our governments fail to act, we must emulate the tactic that worked in helping to end apartheid in South Africa. We must enact a campaign of boycott, divestment and sanctions against Israel. This call came from Palestinian civil society. Society back in 2005. And this call has been taken up by many people of goodwill around the world. There is no parity in this conflict. This is not a conflict of equals. We are looking at the fourth biggest military power in the world against an oppressed Palestinian people. The boycott movement can only help to level the playing field for any future negotiations. This is why we ask you to join the movement with us. Join the movement for boycott, divestment, and sanctions. The boycott is a simple, effective, and peaceful tactic that can bring about parity in this conflict. We would like to commend and thank all of those brave businesses that came out during the week and supported the boycott. And we would like to strongly condemn the team of Hasbara propagandists that have attacked those businesses relentlessly. The team of people employed by this embassy who've attacked and bullied those people all week. They need our support. We're standing on the right side of history. Now, on top of the boycott, which is something you can all carry out yourselves, it's something my colleague Martin Quigley will talk more about, we are asking Irish companies like CRH to divest from their holdings in Israel until Israel ends its brutal occupation, ends the siege of Gaza, and complies with international law. The IPSC, the Ireland-Palestine Solidarity Campaign, is not just a grassroots organisation. We're also a lobby group. And last week and the week before, we made sure that every politician in this country got a copy of our briefing document, which outlines the background to the conflict, but also our recommendations for sanctions against Israel. Israel must be excluded from the preferential Euromed trading agreement of which it is party. Under Article 2 of that agreement, all parties must respect human rights, and it clearly and flagrantly does not. We are also calling for our government to support an arms embargo against Israel. We are calling for a ban on the import of Israeli goods into this country. We are calling for the expulsion of the Israeli ambassador to Ireland. I'd just like to say this has gone on too long. I have stood on stages all over Dublin, all over Ireland too many times. I'm not even that old. This has gone on too long. In fact, this has gone on 66 years too long. And each day that it continues, it brings more shame on the world, more shame on the international community. We must build a mass boycott, divestment and sanctions movement against Israel until it complies with international law, and until Palestinian freedom, justice and equality are achieved. Without this, there will be no lasting peace in the region. We cannot take this time to stand idly by and do nothing. We cannot come back here again in 2 months or 2 years and do this all over again. The time has come for everyone in Ireland to stand